Ah, the atmosphere. That thin haze that nourishes and protects us against the unforgiving extreme of the airless cosmos. But you're an astronautical engineer, and that air you breathe is also an impenetrable molasses, wreaking havoc on your lovely designs. Hi, my name is Stan, and I like to draw spaceships. What to do with the atmosphere? There are a lot of passionately differing opinions, but for launching things into orbit, it is the primary obstacle to overcome, other than, of course, gravity. Rockets generally seek to spend as little time in the atmosphere as possible. They launch vertically to slice through the thickest parts near the surface of the Earth, seeking thinner air and less aerodynamic resistance in the upper atmosphere. There, they can get going really fast on the way to zero resistance vacuum. Spaceplanes use the atmosphere. They save weight on oxidizer by sucking in oxygen from the air with intakes. They use wings to generate lift, taking advantage of the classical efficiency of aircraft flight to gain altitude. They then switch to rocket engines in the thin, high-altitude air. As we shall see, reusing the launch vehicle adds a wrinkle of complexity that makes the choice between rocket and spaceplane a tricky subject. An important idea to understand is the ballistic coefficient. Without going into the math, you can get a rough intuition about it by conducting an experiment. Throw a paper airplane with fairly broad wings in relation to its length. This represents an object with a low ballistic coefficient. Now throw a narrow, dart-shaped airplane with a mass near the center of gravity, like a paperclip. This represents an object with a high ballistic coefficient. The Falcon 9 is a partially reusable rocket, which means that it has to interact with the atmosphere leaving for space and returning for Earth. At launch, it's basically a spear with a bullet-shaped nose weighing over 500,000 kilograms. The exhaust plume is fast and dense, redirecting the turbulent flow far behind the rocket. This gives the Falcon 9 a fairly high ballistic coefficient early on. Mass drops rapidly, but so does air density. And when the boost stage finally separates, the fully fueled second stage has its own stable ballistic properties as it continues to airless vacuum. The returning boost stage is nearly empty and bottom heavy. It is on a parabolic trajectory that it needs to correct, so it reorients itself engines first using cold gas thrusters. A quick boost back burn of 3 of the 9 engines reshapes the parabola back towards the landing site. When it starts to interact strongly with the atmosphere again, the nearly empty tube above the engines acts like the feathers on a shuttlecock, keeping the center of mass forward and giving the boost stage a low ballistic coefficient. The boost stage deploys grid fins, which simultaneously provide more drag and actuate to steer the giant lawn dart towards its landing target. Firing the engines provides a buffer against re-entry heating, while also slowing down. With a few drops left in the tank, a final burn brings the velocity to zero at the exact moment the gear touches down, and the throttle is instantly cut. The Skylon is a proposed spaceplane that launches from a conventional runway. Its immense size and shape also give it a high ballistic coefficient when fully fueled, which will matter since much of its journey is horizontal through the thick parts of the atmosphere. Previous designs for air-breathing spaceplanes ran into a serious limitation in the form of air friction growing so strong it would simply melt the engine. Skylon Sabre engines get around this by running its supply of cryogenic liquid hydrogen through a fine mesh of micropipes. The incoming hypersonic air must navigate around the hundreds of tiny pipes, but in the process is flash cooled to negative 150 degrees Celsius in a microsecond before reaching the compression and combustion chambers. Past Mach 5.5, the engines switch to rocket mode and carry it to space. When returning from space, Skylon is back to its dry mass, or the mass before you add propellant. This means that its large surface area in relation to its now much smaller mass works with the upper atmosphere to slow it down earlier. In other words, it now has a low ballistic coefficient, much like the broad-winged paper airplane. Moving slower means Skylon can use reinforced ceramic and active water cooling in its heat shielding. It then glides to a runway landing, much as the space shuttle does. This is a pretty high altitude overview of the ways engineers have scratched their heads about getting through the atmosphere. There's a dizzying ecosystem of strange and beautiful designs out there, as people have been working out solutions about this for a long time. Links below to some of the more interesting ideas. Stan Draws Spaceships now has a Patreon page. See the link below, and if you'd like to see more episodes more frequently, please consider donating. Thanks for watching Stan Draws Spaceships.